In today's video, we'll see the concept of an ideal constant voltage source, understand real voltage sources, and explore the implications of the internal resistance in a real voltage source. Starting with the ideal constant voltage source. Often depicted as a circle, marked with a plus and a minus sign, with a V indicating its constant voltage level. The beauty of this source is its constant voltage across the terminals, unaffected by the current drawn by any load. The current it supplies entirely depends on the load's resistance, denoted as RL. Were we to plot this behavior on an IV curve, it'd look something like this. But the real world isn't always ideal. Real voltage sources deviate from this perfect behavior, primarily due to a tiny internal resistance introduced in series with the source. Here's how it's conventionally represented. Now, let's delve into the real question. How does this minuscule internal resistance change things? Imagine an ideal voltage source of 5 volts connected to a 100 ohm resistor. Naturally, the voltage across the resistor remains a steady 5 volts. However, when we introduce a real voltage source with an internal resistance, let's say 3 ohms, what happens? This configuration mimics a voltage divider. The exact voltage across our load resistor? We can find it using this equation. For an in-depth exploration of this, our voltage divider video has you covered. With our numbers, the resulting voltage? Approximately 4.85 volts. A slight dip, but not catastrophic. But let's shrink our load resistance to 10 ohms and recalculate. Now, the load voltage plummets to roughly 3.85 volts, a marked departure from our target. From this, we discern a pattern. As the load resistance nears the voltage source's internal resistance, the supplied voltage veers further from our ideal. Consequently, in real-world voltage sources, manufacturers labor to whittle down this internal resistance, ensuring the output remains as faithful to the ideal as possible. I trust you found this exploration enlightening. As always, thank you for tuning in.